you, sir. I wouldn't want to miss this.
We're having such trouble contacting the British sub.
Maybe they've stopped for tea.
I find that in very bad taste, old boy.
Royal Navy 371 calling Stalag 13. Come in, Stalag 13. Over.
Colonel Hogan here. Glad you could read us. We were getting worried when you didn't answer our call.
Nothing to worry about, old boy. The Jerrys have had a destroyer tracking us, but we managed to give him the slip just in time for tea.
I'm not putting a knock on Carter. You know, I think he's a splendid fellow, and he did a marvellous job building that part for the transmitter. But I just think you should have sent me out to deliver it to the underground.
Not at tea time, old boy. Thought of anything of you, Freddy?
I would be glad to demonstrate for you.
Mm-hmm. That's a good idea.
Check the gun, bearer.
Everything is in order, Buena.
Thank you. See that box?
Mm-hmm.
That's a charging rhinoceros.
Buena, that pail down there is a leopard. Buena, there's a big bull elephant coming by that sign.
Kirk. Now you've gone too far.
How about that?
You, Kirk, you're kidding.
Where'd you get Freddy that outfit?
Oh, I just took one of LeBeau's old fatigue suits. Lengthened the trousers a bit, and it was perfect.
Don't be so funny.
Oh, no, you're that sensitive, LeBeau.
I am not sensitive about my height, but I don't like it that Freddy outranks me.
Now, here is our beloved Führer. Adolf Hitler himself!
Germans everywhere! Guten Abend! Der Führer speaks to you tonight, live from Berlin! I'm happy to report that the war against the enemies of our beloved Third Reich goes well. It is possible that you have heard rumors that Berlin is in ruins, Hamburg is a shambles, and so on. I order you not to believe these things, even if they are true. We are willing, always willing against the enemy.
At the present time, certain negotiations are underway, which will come as a great surprise to the fatherland.
No matter what happens, we will all be together.
In conclusion, I say, tighten your belts, work hard, fight dirty, and no matter what happens,
keep smiling.
Colonel, about our orchestra?
Not now, not now. We are winning the war, but negotiations have started.
Oh, don't worry about it. Hitler's like everybody else. He has his moods.
Of course.
He probably had one of his temper tantrums this morning.
Yes, perhaps he had a bad day at Berchtesgaden.
But you can never tell.
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, you go along running the toughest camp in Germany, and then suddenly, one day, you look out, and through the gate comes a Sherman tank with its pea shooter pointed right at your monocle.
What?
Yeah, yeah. And then out steps a second lieutenant, 19 years old, 6'4", a high school senior from Wichita, Kansas. And he says, "Sir, you are my prisoner." Very correct. And if you move, he shoots you.
Colonel, I'm going to play in your orchestra.
Thank you, sir.
You are sitting in my chair.
Sorry. Carried away. I'd get rid of that German helmet if I were you. It's got that Hun feeling about it. And you don't have to worry about going to the Russian front.
the Russian front's coming here.